Though a first timer in Parliament, he made his name as a young man who dared the mighty, especially when he successfully rallied Parliament to pass a resolution for the then powerful Prime Minister Amama Mbabazi, Foreign Affairs Minister Sam Kutesa, and then Energy Minister Engineer Hilary Onek to step aside to allow investigations into allegations of bribery in the oil sector. With Valentine's Day around the corner, many wonder whether the vocal MP is as vocal when it comes to matters of the heart. Many call it love. That
miracles. You know, most times you're seen on camera on issues of corruption, on legislation. Mm. And people ask, is Honorable Kalanga even romantic at all? Does he have a romantic side?
I honestly want to believe that I am like any other human being with the five senses. And certainly, me too, I also have feelings. So, as to whether I'm romantic or not, that's for some people. That's not for me to decide. But I think we are all human beings. We all love to be loved. And love is important, and it's very, very important because... on a serious note, I believe if in this country we loved each other, we'd have lots and lots of progress, because we wouldn't even have corruption, because we would care about what happens to others.
So what is the vocal MP's idea of romance? What would he do that passes as romantic in his eyes?
Romance, what would be the Gerard Karuhanga idea of romance?
What would I define as romance? I think it's the expression, for me it would be an expression of love to this other person, this partner. And maybe you go and a little extra mile to do what you've not done before, or do what you've always done but in an extraordinary way. And things like if you probably never prepared a meal for your partner, you could do it that day. If you could, you could go out and either, if you have never gone, maybe swimming or going for a bash, or give her a treat, or she gives him a treat that has not happened before.
With the love frenzy all over the place, I put the question of what the MP will be up to come 14th of February, the Valentine's Day.
Valentine's Day, honestly, has been a day that somehow passes without so much participation, or it has been largely like any other day in my life. But this time, this year, I want to do something different. I want to go. I understand that there are many young people are going to be doing, they are celebrating sports in a rather different way. I mean, celebrating Valentine's in a rather different way by engaging in sports activities. They will be doing lots of running and playing all sorts of games in different institutions. So I'm going to participate in those activities where we'll be doing all sorts of sports and physical activities. One, in a way, is... use it as an opportunity to promote sports and also keep healthy and fit.
Stories are always out there, sweet and bitter. As people share their most outstanding Valentine's memories, we ask the youthful Karuhanga what he holds as the most memorable Valentine.
By those of the many people out there who are couples, they could enjoy. I think for me, Valentine's is largely an activity of the two individuals. If you choose to go out there and have dinner or go home and the man cooks for his wife and stuff like that, I think it's exciting.
With the clock ticking to the day, loved and hated in equal measures, the MP looks forward to participating in a youth sports gala. What is your idea of a great Valentine? Sabiti Joseph, WC.